nor come as any surprise, the starting goaltenders will be the same as they have been throughout this entire series, and in the case of the respective hockey teams throughout the entire playoffs. Gene Chiarello will go for the London Knights tonight. 24 appearances in the postseason, 3.18 average with one shutout, 15-9 record, 9-12 save percentage. Corey Campbell on the right, 3.06 GA in 20 appearances, 15-5 record, 9.06 save percentage. We've hit off the top, take 16 wins in the postseason to make the Memorial Cup. We have two teams at 15, and baby, this is it. Bill Prisniak, the dean of officials in the OHL, will be the referee tonight. The linesman Steve Miller and Scott Hoberg. And we will get the following matchup for the Bulls as they're going to send out Stanley between Crawford and Campbell. So right off the bat, we're seeing a departure in this lineup change for the Belleville Bulls. Lawmaster and Jacobson back in the blue line. Big line for London throughout this series and throughout the playoffs, and that is Petteri between Barch and Kostopoulos. Back on the blue line will be the veteran Metcalf, as well as number six, Alex Henry. Game seven underway as Mike Jacobson brings it into the London zone. He comes around the net on the backhand, turns, dumps it off the boards. Campbell behind the net, centering. Crawford, point blank shot right on. And the Bulls came oh so close. Right off the bat, Jacobson back on an icing touch up. And the Bulls executing beautifully off the opening faceoff.
Great job by Mike Jacobson to carry the puck deep into London territory, get it to Chris Stanley, and Stanley fed Glenn Crawford in front of the London net, point blank, and Chiarello made the pad save, and an excellent opportunity for Belleville off the top. And of course, first goal, Jack, no matter what anyone says, first goal in this game, I think, very important.
I think so, too. It's going to determine whether the crowd stays in the game or whether they're out of it early. The Knights certainly want to take this capacity crowd of about 3,600 out of it as fast as they can. Faceoff will be to the left of Gene Chiarello, who's made a big stop right off the bat. That should settle him in as the Knights come out of their zone. Outlet to Petteri at the line. Petteri will be handled by Lawmaster as the puck is centered by Kostopoulos, and back to Metcalf on the rebound. Looking for Barch down low, he missed him, and the puck will come off the backboards, and Crawford is away on left wing for Belleville. In across the line, shooting it, far side skate save by Chiarello. And now the Knights are going to bring it right back again as we're wide open in the opening minute. Enrico Fattis slams one wide of the Belleville goal. Don Cicu is now on through center ice, hits the line, shooting, drills one right down the pipe on goal, stopped by Chiarello, and the rebound is on the boards. Here is Fattis getting loose, making a play up on the left wing side. Out to center to Doyle, broken up by Meze off the boards, and Belleville's Justin Papineau will shoot it down. So Cicu is out there along with Reddy and Papineau, and we're seeing all kinds of surprises from Luke Crawford early on. Lawmaster back, second icing call against the Knights. We played 1:23, opening period scoreless, and what a start on Cronin's home building center, Belleville Bulls hockey. Underway, but lots of chances right off the bat. Out through the center ice zone, Jason Lawmaster back behind his line. Ryan Reddy gets the pass, now off the boards, bank pass for Papineau in across the belt or the London line, and Papineau will drop it back in deep. Cicu off the boards, out in front of the net, pass across, intended for Reddy, but it's off the mark, and Reddy will set up on the near side. Papineau behind the net, he is stripped of the puck by John Erskine, who had to leave the game with a bit of a head injury the other night in game six, got his bell rung on the hit by Cicu, and there was no further action from the OHL on the hit, and I would say, having seen it many times in the replay, there didn't deserve to be anything else. Mike Jacobson, left point, throwing it in short side. Erskine tied up by Papineau, so he'll kick the puck along the boards. However, they can't get it out. Schaefer works his way from Cicu onto the right side to Legault. Out at center, the Knights are in three-on-two formation. Legault gets across the line, he's hooked off the puck, and Randy Rowe will get it on and get it out of the zone. Down the ice, picked up by Alex Henry, both teams scrambling for a line change. Passes in the skates of Chris Barch. He mishandles it, gets it back again at his line, and now feeds it to the captain, Petteri, at center. He steps in around Kostopoulos into the slaughter shot. And it's deflected by Nick Policelli into the corner. And it will be played back the other way by London. Bouncing puck in the corner. Bartsch behind the net. Wraparound attempt blocked by Campbell. And Bartsch picks it up again. Throws it in the corner to Petteri. Two Bulls are on him as the puck squirts loose. And Rick Bertrand, who is seeing his first action in this series, on the ice now. It's off Rady Vojevic down the ice. Gene Chiarello will fire it out at center. The Bulls caught in a change. Petteri is onside, hits the line, shooting it. And it's off the boards after being deflected by Campbell. And a close call. So the Knights get another man down low for Kostopoulos. Back into the slot to Bartsch. Tips it to the line to Reynolds. Reynolds with a wrist shot and didn't get much on it. However, the Knights maintain possession. Petteri, another shot. And this one's deflected away, and the Bulls will bank it out. Off the boards it rolls. Down the ice. Icing coming up against Belleville this time. Reynolds in there. Just ahead of Branko Radivojevic.
Well, the Bulls got caught on a bad change, Jack. And that gave the Knights a couple of good opportunities deep in Belleville territory. And just at the time when the Petteri, Bartsch, Kostopoulos line was on the ice, which if, when it's with London Knights is the last line you want to see.
Problem is you're going to probably see them every other shift.
They have been by far the Knights' best line. And no matter what stripe you may wear, you have to admire Tom Kostopoulos. He is an excellent, excellent hockey player, a workmanlike guy who will pay the price to score goals.
Lynn Crawford against Rico Fatta. Face off to the left of Corey Campbell. No score. Three shots aside. And Belleville winning the draw. Stanley behind his net. And he can't get it out. It will trickle up on the boards. Derek Campbell waits for it and now clears it. And the Knights, led by Medcalf, back in their own zone. Medcalf gets turned around. Off the right wing side for Doyle at the line. He did, thought he ran offside, but he didn't. And Branislav Meze will play it back the other way. And it's Medcalf again in his own end. Erskine will outlet. Knights led to center by Joel Sherbin. Dumped into the right wing corner. Branislav Meze, ranked ninth by NHL Central Scouting among North American prospects. Getting it out to center ice, and a bouncing puck will find Kelly Patton, and it's going to roll in across the London line. Off the board, Stanley, one-time shot right on, and Chiarello makes that save from 30 feet out. Crawford again in the corner for Belleville. Centering pass out in front, Campbell, backhand shot, and that one skipped just wide. And the Bulls have had a couple of chances out in front of Gene Chiarello. Crawford behind the goal, looks for his centering man. He gets knocked down on the play, then Fatta will get the loose puck. And then he is bumped by Chris Stanley on the forecheck as the puck rolls into the corner, and the Knights are going to ice it away. And the crowd reacting as Lawmaster goes back. We play 15-11, scoreless, opening period, game seven, OHL Finals. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Robinson behind the London net for Belleville. He curls away from Reynolds. Curls again. Still has it in the corner. Can't find anybody to make a play to. Now to Renzi. He's bumped by Henry, and Renzi gets free of the check. Skips behind the net. Pulls out in front and centers. Nobody there for Belleville. And the Knights are going to get it out to the neutral zone. Losing it to Chris Newberry. He will come back inside his own end in front of his net. Hold up and now play it to Robinson. And Robinson's away on the left wing through center ice. Nate Robinson tried to trickle it through the legs of Alex Henry. It didn't work. Now it's back to the line. And getting loose out there is Jay Legault with one man back. Legault, low shot! Beat Campbell. He made the stop and got behind him. But fortunately for the Bulls, it was wide and Belleville ends up taking a penalty. And it looks like Kelly Patton, who took too many penalties the other night, to be honest, in game six. First man off, he took Jay Legault out of the play. He will be gone for interference, the last thing Belleville wanted.
Jay Legault's shot, and it's a good low one that Corey Campbell makes a good stop on, but then doesn't have control of. And it falls, or rather rolls behind him, but luckily for him, not into the empty cage.
And as the puck deflected into the corner, Patton was doing his work on Legault. Interference the call. And London will strike up the power play at 20.7%. overall, but 13.6 on the road. Devils penalty killing 8th in the playoffs at 80.7. Key time to start this game, we're scoreless. Shot left point, right on goal. Rebound out in front of the net. And the Bulls are fortunate to get to it first. Papineau comes up with that and shoots it down the ice. And I say fortunate because it rolled over a London stick. Kostopoulos. Outlets across two lines, and the linesman missed it. And you can hear the linesman in the background. They didn't miss it. Big hit as Ryan Reddy knocks down Rico Fatta. Bulls getting it along the boards to the point, kept in. Erskine losing it. Papineau clears it. And it's back into the neutral zone, and Jay Legault will feed it over to Petiri. The Burlington native will dump it in across the line. Papineau stings it right back down the boards, right to London territory. And another big hit thrown in the neutral zone. This time, Randy Rowe just leveled Jay Legault. Minute and 10 remaining in the penalty to Kelly Patton. In over the line, here is Jason Doyle, shooting it wide on the short side. March behind the net. And looking for a receiver, he plays it in the corner, and Chris Kelly is there. Back to Legault, shot left point, and that one caroms wide of the net, and the Bulls are gonna ricochet this one off the boards as Randy Rowe clears it away. 48 seconds left in the Belleville penalty, no score, closing in on the 7-minute mark of this opening period. Long rink wide feed, Doyle right side, centering pass out in front, shot, right on goal, and there's Campbell with the save, and he jumps and covers up on the rebound.
Good feed to Chris Burns of the London Knights, and he cut to the side of the net. And Corey Campbell didn't give him that short side. And Mike Jacobson in there to clobber Burns, which is, of course, what Bell was looking for, is to clear the front of that net. Good job by Jacobson. Two devastating body checks dealt out in that penalty kill, Jack, by the Bulls. First Ryan Reddy and then Randy Rowe.
37 seconds left in the penalty killing assignment. Henry, right point, dealing down low. It will be Barch to the slot. Doyle is shot blocked. Belleville getting it up. John Chichu had to go off his skate, and he's hauled down. And the crowd calling for a penalty for interference. They won't get it. Doyle in across the line, feeding it off to Barch on the left wing side, back to the point. Henry will get it out in front of the goal. And it's Campbell getting a piece of it. Reynolds picks it up at the top of the near circle. Into the corner, back to Reynolds. Swiped that and cleared up to the line, a bouncing puck out. And that was John Chichu who gave the second effort to clear the zone. Patton about ready to come back on. Doyle still with possession for London. Drives it, blocked by Policelli. Bulls get it up, Crawford might get a breakaway. He's behind the defense, he's in a long, Crawford shoots, he scores!
The stick of Glenn Crawford, who's coming off the bench, and he's away to the races. It's just now Crawford and Chiarello, and Glenn Crawford, who's a very nifty veteran forward in this league, shoves it underneath the sprawling Chiarello.
Glenn Crawford's 13th postseason goal breaks the scoreless tie at 7:47, and the Bulls get a great bounce in the neutral zone, sending Crawford in alone, and he waited until Chiarello made that first move and then just put it underneath his pads, which at that moment were coming out from underneath his feet. And the Bulls draw first blood, Clint Crawford at 7:47. Belleville, in 21 postseason games, have scored the first goal 16 times. Jacobson tries to force a pass through the neutral zone. He'll have to go the other way to Lawmaster, and he'll sail one in. Pulled down by Erskine, called at the line. Nick Policelli getting the assist on the play, and in limited play, Policelli has three assists in this series, which, believe it or not, is second to Kelly Patton among Belleville defensemen. Patton's been chewing up the points, but there haven't been a lot of other points by Belleville defensemen in this series. As a matter of fact, Patton has the only goal by a defenseman by Belleville. They're back inside the London zone. It's going to be out off a stick and taken by Lawmaster at center. Jason Lawmaster off the boards, intercepted by Erskine. Comes to the line shooting, and that's going to come right on goal. The rebound cleared back to the line, but not out. And it's kept in by Jason Metcalf. Turned around the boards. Lawmaster will catch up with this. Sails one back to center, right onto the stick of Metcalf. And Metcalf will play it ahead. Belleville with it. in their own zone. Now coming away, Jacobson's pass. He had not crossed center, but it looks like Ryan Reddy might get there first as Erskine bumped Reddy, and there's no icing on the play. Kostopoulos in the corner, playing it off the boards out to the center ice zone. Belleville getting it back there. Branislav Meze played off the left wing side, off the stick of Reddy, kept in off the tip of the stick of Stanley, and cleared by Kostopoulos. Tichu at center, brings it in, and then is forced off the puck. It's back to center. Meze back to his line, to his right. Return pass from Patton. Now has Reddy open on the left wing side. Reddy will dump it in, Papineau's corner. In after it, Papineau against Medcalf. Played off the boards, as Papineau being watched and barging through is Stanley. He will center it, at least attempt to, and that one's off a London skate back to the line. Tichu with a shot, that ricochets off Petteri, and rebounds out to center, and Petteri almost got loose. The Knights take it up at center and cross the line offside. Belleville 1, London nothing. 10:30 remaining in the first. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Shift, Jason Medcalf got carried away and goes off for slashing at 9:30, and the Belleville power play, simply the best in the OHL in the postseason at 33%. That's 33 goals on 100 chances. Going to work, London's penalty kill at 76%, 12th in the playoffs. Belleville gain the zone, Crawford to Lawmaster, back to the left point. Lawmaster hits Crawford on the left wing boards, working his way down deep. However, he lost the puck as he tried to make a play, and Reynolds is there, and he shoots it down the ice. Bulls will come back and get reorganized as we are just shy of the midway point of this opening period. 1-0 Belleville. Long lead pass intended for Stanley. He can't corral it at center. Now it bounces onto the stick of Chris Kelly. Kelly gets it across the line for Legault, and Legault a weak shot on Campbell, and he'll stop that and feed the near side. Crawford dumps it back. Belleville looking disorganized right now. Crawford will get it back from Lawmaster. Now it's out to center. Vladi Vojevic with speed at the line, shoots it, scores!
Franco Vladi Vojevic, your classic power forward. And he is gonna come in over the London blue line and just let it rip. Chiarello throws his glove up, but it's in the top corner of the net before he can get his glove anywhere near the puck. Vladi Vojevic has a howitzer.
He also has his seventh goal of the postseason. It's a power play goal. Vladi Vojevic leading all rookies in scoring in the postseason, but of course you have to temper that with the fact he's played more games than most of them, but that's his 24th point, 10-23. Bulls take a 2-0 lead with Vladi Vojevic connecting on the power play. What a rocket from about 35 feet out.
His seventh goal in the playoffs, scored by number 22, Franco Vladi Vojevic. The assist number 16, Glenn Crawford. And number 4, Jason Lawmaster.
Hopefully you can hear the PA. Crawford and Lawmaster drawing the assists on Vladi Vojevic's seventh goal at 10:23. And Belleville with a 2-0 lead and 9:20 remaining in the opening period.
Glenn Crawford picked up from the Sudbury Wolves early in the season, well, mid-season actually. Fifth year in the OHL, picked up for depth. Then when Chris Stanley went down with a broken arm February 5th, Crawford became even more important. But he has spearheaded the two-goal lead in this game 7.
One goal, one assist. He's on the face-off dot, wins it. Campbell feeds it around the boards. Left wing side, Stanley taking a regular shift tonight. Probably the first time he's done that since February the 5th. As they've been working him easily back into the lineup after he broke his arm in four places February the 5th in Kingston. Belleville will ice this one away. And we have 9 minutes left in the first. Bulls 2, Knights nothing. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey.
Hey,
Welcome back to the Yardman Arena, Jack Miller and Tom Gavey. And again, welcome to listeners, of course, in the Quiddy area on CJBQ and in the Ottawa Valley on OSR 1200. Knights win the draw, and working it out in front of the net, centering it, was Jancevski. Bulls will intercept and send it down the ice, and Rady Vojevic in a hurry down there against Chris Barch. The two players go down, and Kostopoulos will pick up the loose puck and give away. Chaplin! Wraparound attempt, it came through the crease, and Randy Rowe couldn't get a stick on it. It's cleared around the boards, Patton pinching, and he won't get it, but he does take the man, and Chaplin keeps the puck in the offensive zone. Randy Rowe throws it in the crease again. Knocked out this time by Barch. Back to the line to Patton, a drive right on. And it kicks off Chiarello and out of play.
Bulls having the London Knights in their own zone now, all around the London net. And this is, of course, the Belleville that we've become accustomed to for much of these playoffs, although in games 5 and 6, they weren't as evident. But they've come out flying tonight, and I have to look back, Jack, to two big hits delivered during a penalty kill early in this first period by Randy Rowe and Ryan Reddy, and they really seem to set the tone for the Belleville Bulls.
Well, the Knights now, though, keep your head up. There weren't too many hits administered in game number 6 on Sunday night in London. And you don't think there would be that many on this big ice surface in Belleville. Been two beauties here, as you point out. Justin Papineau gets it in deep. Chiarello out of his net, plays it off on the boards. Papineau again, dealing it in behind for Chichu. Reddy takes it behind the goal, pulls out in front, jams a shot right on. And there's a rebound in front, back to the line it goes. Lawmaster shooting it, and it deflects off a crowd in front of the net over the glass behind Gene Chiarello.
Luke Crawford has changed up his lines, Jack, in this game, as you've mentioned, and One thing that he did was he reunited the kid line of Robinson, Newberry, and Renzi, but he's also got his, what I call, all your eggs in one basket line of Papineau, Reddy, and Chichu. That's his three top scorers in these playoffs, and obviously three potent guys. But Belleville, of course, for those who have followed the playoffs know, are not a team that goes by one line anyway.
Not normally three and four lines. Belleville winning the faceoff as Papineau slams it right off a London player, and it comes back to center. Mike Jacobson moving it ahead to Reddy at the center ice stripe, runs into Reynolds. Chichu picks up the puck, gains the zone, centering pass! What a save in front! Chichu hit Papineau coming in from the right hand side, and Chiarello got across the crease to make the stop. That had 3-0 written all over it, and the Bulls continue to press. Reddy behind the net, centering, Chichu scores!
And the Belleville Bulls won the battle along the boards, and that's where you'll win hockey games. And then Jonathan Chichu, you don't see the backhand work very often, but he tucked it up underneath the crossbar to beat Chiarello. Hell of a job there by Mark Chaplin on that goal as well.
He came up with the puck behind the net, and Chichu, parked just outside the crease, was on his backhand on a really tough angle. And I'm not even sure that puck had to have eyes to get through on the short side. Chichu with his 11th postseason goal at 12:28. It's his 6th goal in this series. They've all come on home ice. Belleville has taken a 3-0 lead at 12:28 of the first.
His 11th goal of the playoffs, scored by number 19, Jonathan.
Knights will throw it in the Belleville zone. And around the goal, and Belleville's Kelly Patton working on Sherman. Loose puck behind the net. Doyle tries to slam one in front of the goal, and it's intercepted, and Stanley comes back now for Belleville. Long shot coming up. Butterfly stance for Chiarello, and he was fighting that shot from well out of the blue line. Belleville getting it at the line, and now it's out. Derek Campbell will pick it up and slide it in. Under 7 to go in this opening period. Rico Fatta passes in front of his net intended for Erskine. Instead, it's played by Stanley, tipped into the corner. Erskine and Derek Campbell tie up. Erskine able to get his stick on this, and now Metcalf will pick it up on the far boards, dealing out to the line and out. And here's Crawford and Meze going back for this, and Meze will pick it up in front of his net. He is fighting it. Branislav Meza gets turned around, lays it gently up to the wing, and Rady Boyevich onto Chaplin on the left side against Erskine. Chaplin is hauled down on the play, and the Bulls are able to come up with the puck nonetheless. Rady Boyevich is knocked down and is picked up by Legault at center. Jacobson hits him, the Bulls break back, and there's going to be a penalty, I think, against Belleville for tripping. That was right after Bill Prisniak let London get away with a couple of pretty good hits, as well as an interference. But it looks like Lawmaster will be the penalized player. And Bill Prisniak didn't win many friends with that particular call after what he just let go. 3-0, Belleville. London going to the power play when we come back on Cronin's Home Building Center, Bulls Hockey. Are on their second power play. Richard Petteri shooting it in from center ice. Kostopoulos hit on the boards by Patton. Now he directs it back to the point. Jay Legault will get it. There's the snapshot that just missed the net. And Alex Henry gets over there, not in time. Dustin Papineau is there first, and he gets it out to center ice. Jay Legault plays it off the right wing boards. Tom Kostopoulos at the line and got hit, and the Bulls clear it out. And a minute and 15 remaining in this power play for the Knights. Legault is forced behind his net and now starting it away for London. Up the middle, Rico Fatta brings it in across the line with Petteri going to the goal. Fatta back to Kostopoulos, and he lifts a high one over top of the Belleville net. Mike Jacobson gets it back to the line, and it jumps on the stick of Metcalf, who now fakes an injury as John Chichu and Metcalf bumped, and Metcalf went down like he'd been hit with something with a caliber behind it. And he is, of course, we've seen that many times. Bill Prisniak wasn't buying it. Belleville still continues the work of the penalty-killing team as Policelli gets it down the ice. 38 seconds left in the Lawmaster penalty. Knights coming out of their zone, led by Legault on the left wing side. Hits center, dumps it in, and then he'll take a spot on the bench as the Knights change up. Jacobson moving it quickly to get it to center. 25 seconds left in the penalty against Jason Lawmaster. Loose puck inside the Bulls zone. Policelli can't clear it. Kelly walks its way down into the corner. Back to the line to Erskine. Back to Kelly in the circle. Can't get his stick unlocked. Now feeds it deep. Puck ping-pongs off his skate. Finds an opening at the line and comes back through center ice. 5 seconds left in the penalty. Knights are back in their own zone. Dansevsky banks it, turned over. Mezzi is there and shoots it down the ice. Belleville back to full strength. 4:05 remaining in this opening period. 3-0 Bulls in the lead. Then Crawford pulls one down. Now he picks it off. Handing off shot. Scores! Papineau makes it 4-0.
And what a period Glenn Crawford's having. This time he sets up Papineau just as the London power play ends. Second time in this period, Knights have been burned off a power play. And Crawford gets it to Papineau, and Papineau so often scores from in close, off to the side of the net, and he does it again for Belleville.
Justin Papineau was going top shelf all the way. Both he and Crawford had worked in pretty deep on the play after Crawford slipped past Erskine, made the play across Papineau, the left-handed shot from the right side, picked the top shelf, his 21st postseason goal, coming at 16:02. It is 4-0 Belleville. And you're right, what a period by Glenn Crawford. 4-0 Bulls under 4 minutes to go in this opening period. Alex Henry will play it up to the line and out. No, not out. Kept in by Derek Campbell. And the Ottawa native will get it in deep. On the boards, Campbell picking it up again. Chris Stanley is there. Beats it back for Derek Campbell. He plays it into the corner, and Alex Henry is there. Just the one assist, I believe, and that would be to Glenn Crawford, who has 3 points in the period. Rico Fatta at center. Pass intended for Mazzucca, off the skate of Jacobson. Now it's brought back by Lawmaster in across the line on the left wing. And Lawmaster on his backhand behind the net and around into the corner. Holds up on the half boards and then flicks it in deep. 4-0 Belleville. Reynolds coming away, getting it out to center. The Knights will pick it up there with Thatta hitting the line. Dropping it back, Barch's shot, and that one is off the glass and out of play. 3:02 left in the first, 4-0 Belleville. This is Grohmann's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Belleville net, centering attempt by the Knights off Mezzi's stick into the corner. Belleville getting it to the line. Jansevski keeps it in and puts it past Chaplin into the corner. Mezzi behind his net. Back on the left wing side for Chaplin. He flicks it out to the center ice zone. Jansevski intercepted by Rowe. Hits the line and over. Backhand tries to split the defense. And he almost got himself through there, and Jansevski reached back and got him at the last moment. And now the Knights are going to shove it down the ice right on Corey Campbell. He will cover up on the play. 2:28 left, first period. We will take a break on Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Boyevich, Chichu, and Papineau. They've all scored for Belleville in this period. Back to Henry, the line, screenshot, deflects in front, scores! Kelly is there for the Knights. Getting a big goal as nobody picked up Chris Kelly all alone in front of the Belleville net.
He was left alone off to the side of Corey Campbell, short side, and he tucks it in that short side. And that's a huge goal for the London Knights, Jack, because they were in danger of getting blown out of this building, but now they get it back to within three and they score late in the period, just 2:20 left on the clock.
Chris Kelly with his ninth goal of the postseason, and you're right, a huge one as the Knights have to take it a goal at a time, but not a defenseman near Chris Kelly, all alone and off the deflection off Henry at 17:40. Knights get one back. And Chris Kelly had a huge game in game six with a goal and three assists. Alex Henry coming out of his own zone. He had the only assist on that goal. And down the ice it goes with 2 minutes remaining in the period. Lawmaster held off the puck. Now it's centered in front for Doyle, and he's wrapped up by Mike Jacobson. Off to the far boards, Chris Stanley gets it to the line, but the Belleville net's been knocked loose. And it would appear that a penalty is being called against Lawmaster again. And so Bill Prisniak handing Belleville their third penalty of the game, second against Lawmaster, and all three have been against Belleville defensemen. So the Knights are going to get a chance to cut the deficit in half.
Belleville's penalty number four, Jason Lawmaster. 2 minutes for delay of game at 18:05.
And a delay of game penalty to boot. That was not a delay of game penalty that caught us into this trouble in game five, although an unintentional one, because the goaltender put it over short glass and out of play, but this one was intentional. So Lawmaster goes off, and that's not a good penalty to be taking. That could be a real bad penalty. Knights on their third power play. Erskine on the near boards. Back into the corner. 4-1 is the Belleville lead, but the Knights with a power play here in the late stages of the opening period. Ryan Reddy gets to a loose puck first on the boards and sends it down the ice. Minute and a half remaining in the opening period. 4-1 Belleville. The Knights coming out of their zone. Off the boards at center, then Padden is there and sends one right down the ice. Erskine with Papineau closing in on him. Papineau ties up the defenseman who just does get it away to center. Policelli is there, plays it ahead off the glove of Thatta. Papineau fights for the puck and gets it. And he slips it on the outside around Erskine down the ice. Minute and 7 remaining in this period. A minute and 10 to go in the power play. Rico Thatta at his line. Drops it back. Legault will have to come in on this. He missed, fires on it, just with Chichu in the area. And the Bulls are on it. Rowe will shoot it down the ice. Into the final minute of this opening period. Erskine almost fell down behind the net with Chichu there. He's able to recover and feed Legault. Legault out through the center ice zone. Offside at the line. Tyrion Barch get crossed up. And that will bring about a chance for the Bulls to change up penalty killers with 42.3 left in the opening period.
Knight's not able to do anything with this third power play. Give some of the credit to Belleville penalty killers, but the Knights really have struggled throughout their three power plays. And the only problem with taking a 4-0 lead that this early in the game, Jack, it's now 4-1, but when it was 4-0, is you lose some of that desperation that makes you play so well. And so sometimes a big lead too early can be troublesome.
Although you'd rather have it than not.
Definitely.
Out at center, Knights on the attack. It finds its way to Doyle. He's offside again. And Bart slams the puck into the corner in disgust. Doyle wasn't watching.
No.
He could have held up for the pass, and he just wandered across the line before the pass got his way. 25 seconds left in the period. 30 in the penalty.
Belleville's defense gets in trouble when they don't move their feet. When they get flat-footed and start waving at the puck with their sticks, that's when London gets in behind them and causes problems.
And because they're not moving their feet, there's no chance to catch up with the speedy forwards. Kelly Padden off the draw. The Bulls have been very good executing on the faceoffs in this period. That was a real problem in London the other night. Outlet, Doyle, right into the shin pads. Meze turns it away. 8 seconds left. Knights deep in their own zone. Richard Petteri, high flip shot out through center. Branislav Meze corrals it, plays it away, and the first period comes to an end. And the Bulls getting a huge ovation from his sellout crowd at the Yardman Arena in full value for a 4-1 lead after 20 minutes of play. Welcome back to the Yardman Arena. Big first period by Belleville, leading 4-1, out shooting London 12-11, despite being shorthanded three times. Still 4 seconds left in Jason Lawmaster's penalty. And just waiting for the clock to be reset to 20, and they seem to be having some trouble with that. Now it is done, and we're ready for period number two. Crawford, Radivojevic, Chichu, and Papineau for Belleville. Kelly has scored for London. Off the draw, wisped inside the Belleville zone. Jacobson wisps it right back down the ice. Belleville is back to full strength and a perfect 3-for-3 on the penalty kill. Knights out at center, losing it. Reddy is there, and he dumps it in deep again. And Jason Medcalf will wait for this. Turn it off the left wing boards. Back to the line. Lawmaster is there. Shoots it. Scores! Deflected in front by Chichu.
Jason Lawmaster came out of the penalty box and stayed on the ice, gets the drive away, and Jonathan Chichu plants himself in front of Gene Chiarello and redirects the shot over Chiarello's shoulder. Nothing that Gene Chiarello could do on that.
And that is three times in this game that the Bulls have scored just after killing off a penalty. Jason Lawmaster, right out of the box, sets up at the right point. Looks in, he sees Chichu in front. That's where he makes the play. And Chichu extends his stick, and right off the toe, deflects it in the far side. His 12th goal of the postseason. Lawmaster will draw an assist. It's 5-1 Belleville.
18, Jonathan Chichu. The assist number 4, Jason Lawmaster.
The only assist on the goal, and the Bulls are looking for more as they get it down low, and the Knights will break it up and get it out to center ice. It will be one-handed by Stanley to the London line. Erskine is there, just does get it through for Schaefer. Schaefer to Fatta on the right wing against Crawford. No room for Fatta, and the Bulls jump on a turnover and shoot it down the ice. They will be called here as Erskine touches up. Minute and eight into the second. Bulls strike again. 5-1 now on Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. at the Yardman Arena. Jack Miller and Tom Gavey face off to the left of the Belleville net. 5-1 Bulls. They have possession in their own zone. And Chris Stanley will move them out. Out of the right wing side, it's center off the boards. Patton tipping it for Campbell. Campbell will shoot it in. Chiarello leaves it behind the net. Erskine will turn it to the far boards. And the Knights will pick it up from there. Jay Legault coming away on right wing to center. Jay Legault cuts into the middle. Weaving on his backhand, dumps it into the offensive territory. Corey Campbell behind the net will one-hand it. Fata lets it go to Erskine. Takes a shot, missed the net by a wide margin. And a penalty coming up against London. Well away from the play, and I think Jay Legault is going off.
You might begin, although there's still a lot of time left in this hockey game, you may begin to see even now frustration from the London Knights.
Belleville scores on this power play, you'll see a bunch of frustration. It's at 5-1, and that was a needless penalty for Jay Legault, nowhere near the play. 1:41 into the second period. Belleville is 1-for-1 on the power play. And this faceoff will be just outside the Bulls' blue line. Papineau, Chichu, and Reddy. Kelly Patton will move back along with Randy Rowe. Penalty killing unit starts with Richard Petteri on the faceoff dot. Belleville winning the faceoff, and it will be Rowe pushing it to Patton, right back to Rowe again, and he'll have to catch up with this on the boards. Randy Rowe dribbles it out. Now the ball's off Patton, he can't control it, and it will be Rowe coming over to rescue the puck at his line. He'll bring it out to center and now shoots it in. Kicks off the boards toward the net. Gene Chiarello will drop the mitt and will gobble it up. And we'll get the faceoff in the London zone to the left. Gene Chiarello.
An area that was a weakness during the regular season becomes a strength during the postseason, the power play. And the Bulls coming into this game, as you had mentioned, at 33%, leading the OHL in the playoffs with the extra man. And I think, as far as the Bulls were concerned, the big difference was they started to use their point much more effectively. It was a problem during the regular season, but especially Jonathan Chicho and Randy Rowe have done an excellent job back there.
And at the right point off the draw, will shoot it. Screenshot, rebound in front of the net. Kostopoulos got his stick on that at the last moment. Rowe at the point will keep it in, down low to Chicho. John Chicho now with 7 goals, all at home in this series. Pass behind the net, intended for Papineau. It squeezes through to Justin, back to the line to Patton. Patton to Papineau, top of the circle, will shoot it. And he just missed the top corner on the far side. Came off the glass, back to the point. Rowe sends it in deep, Henry mishandling it. Reddy centers, and it comes all the way back to the line. Kept in by Rowe. It looked for a moment like it was going to be down the ice. Belleville keeping it in again. Now this time it's going to be knocked out. Tom Kostopoulos after a loose puck. Corey Campbell will wait for it, and then one-handed off to the far boards. And Rowe is hammered by Kostopoulos on the wall. Still makes the play to Patton. Patton now has to come behind his net for it. 45 seconds left in the goal penalty. Papineau out to Reddy at center. Reddy forced to the wide side by Barch. He is at the end of his shift. He'll dump it in and then step off as the Bulls get a change. Lawmaster into Chichu. Closing in on the backhand shot, and it just about made it to the net. It was stopped in front, but a slashing penalty has been taken by the Knights, and they will be short 2 men for 31 seconds. 5-1, Belleville. We'll take a break in Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. About a half a minute, 31 seconds in Legault's penalty, and it's the goaltender who gets the slashing penalty, Gene Chiarello at 3:10. And the faceoff will be to the right of Gene Chiarello, but the Knights win it, and they'll start off by sending Belleville down the ice. Lawmaster and Chichu are back. Glenn Crawford with a huge first period, a goal and 2 assists, now has it on the left wing side. He will wheel his way on through center, pick his way in across the line. It's Crawford still with it with Rady Vojevic going to the net. Pass goes to the line to Lawmaster. Gets it back from Stanley from the slot. Shot right on. And Chiarello makes the save and gives up nothing to Rady Vojevic, who is posted just outside the crease.
Branko Radivojevic, just one of the Belleville rookies who's having a tremendous playoff, and that's why folks here in Belleville are so excited about this team. Not just the fact that they've had such an amazing season this year and running the playoffs, but that things look as good or better for next year.
Faceoff will be to the left of the London net. 5-1 Bulls in the lead. Chichu with two goals. Crawford with a goal and two assists. Chichu will come in for this faceoff. Against Rico Fatta. And the puck splits the defense. Papineau will have to come back behind his line. Legault is out of the box. Belleville still with a one-man advantage as Radivojevic gets the pass, pounds it on goal from the right side, and the save is made by Chiarello. Now it rolls over on the other side. It's played back to the line by Papineau to Rowe. Rowe will set up and shoot it, and another good stop and an interference penalty against Ryan Reddy. So Bill Prisniak will even it up here with Reddy going off for interference.
He's going to say that Reddy was interfering with goaltender Gene Chiarello.
So the Bulls' two-man advantage goes for naught, and as a matter of fact, in a minute and 15 seconds, London will have a 45-second power play. Belleville 5, and London 1. And these teams are aspiring to the national championship, the Memorial Cup, in Ottawa, and it will start on Saturday, the Ottawa Civic Center. The 67s will be so relieved to actually play a hockey game, and they will do so against the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League champions, the Acadie Bathurst Titans. The winner of this game will face the Calgary Hitmen on Sunday afternoon at 4 o'clock. Off the draw down the ice, Belleville zone. Lawmaster takes a bump from Legault. Just did get the puck off. Jacobson ahead. Chichu on to the left wing to Crawford. Lawmaster into the play for the pass out in front. He deflected it right on goal, and Chiarello stood his ground. Now the Knights at center, and a solid hit thrown by Crawford on Jansevski. Mike Jacobson fans on his clear out. Now he's on the backhand in front of his net, and he'll guide it on to John Chichu on the right wing side. And then he took an elbow from Jansevski, but not before propelling that down the ice. 35 seconds left in the London penalty. Minute and 20 to go in Reddy's. 5-1 Belleville. This is Jacobson with Chichu open for the pass on the right wing boards at center. Long shoot down into the mid of Chiarello, and he gets a bit of the Bronx cheer from the highly partisan crowd here at the Yardman Arena. Knights send it down the ice. It's going to roll in on Corey Campbell, and Chris Kelly got behind the defense but could not catch up with the puck. And we have played 4:52 of the second period of play.
And I know we've gotten late in the season, Jack, later than ever for this Belleville Bulls team, because I just saw a mosquito.
And it's been hibernating in here all winter.
But talking about the Bulls youngsters, Jack, and Branko Radivojevic, he leads the Ontario Hockey League in playoff scoring coming in tonight with 23 points. They've got the second leading scorer with Kelly Padden, fourth with Mike Renzi, Chris Newberry sixth out of the top 10 rookie scorers, and plus Nate Robinson is up there.
Kind of says a lot about your future.
Sure does.
And again, remember, they played more games than a lot of others, but the fact that they're
there playing
shows that they're playing and contributing. 5-1 Belleville. The veterans have been contributing here big time in this game tonight. Bulls will get the puck down the ice into the London zone. Peter Reynolds, number 44, with Papineau in forechecking. He picks him off. Papineau turns off the boards as the Bulls are about to go shorthanded for 45 seconds. Kelly Padden just does get a pass back from Branislav Meze as the Knights are on their fourth power play. They have yet to score. Belleville will shoot it down the ice. And in deep is Erskine picking it up for the Knights, now playing it up on the right wing side for Bartsch. Rowe cuts him off. Play comes ahead, intended for Kostopoulos. He's checked. Rowe is on it. And a glove pass, a hand pass, is being called against London. And we have 25 seconds remaining in the penalty against Ryan Reddy. 14:30 to go here in the second period.
And as we've mentioned, Belleville has scored very shortly after all three of London's previous power plays. If I had a youngster that I wanted to teach to play the game of hockey and I needed him to watch someone, I think I'd tell him to focus on Randy Rowe. Just watch number 18 every shift. He gives it everything he's got, but he plays it in a controlled manner. He doesn't get overexcited, doesn't overskate the puck, and he's got good offensive capabilities as well.
Things off outside of the Belleville blue line, and right off the draw, Chris Stanley wins it right back down into London territory. And John Erskine is there. Erskine, right wing feed. Doyle will cross center and then shoot it in. Off the boards, it comes in front of the net, tipped by the goaltender Corey Campbell into the corner. Knights will get it back. Now, sharp angle shot, and it snared by Campbell. It was out in front of his eyes. That was not an easy grab by Campbell as the puck was coming across the crease. And he had to reach up. He's left-handed. That's the side the puck was coming from. So it's kind of awkward if you can imagine trying to get your glove turned around to grab it. He did that, and we'll get a face-off to the left of the Belleville net. And 5 seconds left in Reddy's penalty.
And talk about stories of the playoffs. How about Corey Campbell? Rookie goaltender. First takes the job away early in the season from overage Sean Gallant and establishes himself as the number one goalie, and then does this in the playoffs.
Metcalf back at the line. His shot is blocked by Chichu. Now Reddy is out of the box for the pass. He's in over the line. Couldn't get enough speed going to get around the defenseman Metcalf, and it will result in a hit on the boards and a turnover and a loose puck at center. John Chichu. And Fata takes a run at him. And now Legault takes a hit on Chichu from behind. Just, he gives him a punch with his glove in the back of the head. And Bill Prisniak from afar, I don't know how much of it he saw. But Jay Legault trying to work in on Chichu. And he might end up being penalized here. We'll have to wait and see, although Prisniak hasn't indicated anything yet.
Well, we're starting now to see the frustration from the London Knights, and give Jonathan Chichu credit. He never once retaliated, because Prisniak did look around when he heard the fans, but by then Legault was done with what he was doing, and if Chichu had retaliated, that's what Prisniak would have seen.
Shane Legault, in all probability, playing his last season with the Knights. He would have an overage campaign, but I don't think so. Shane Legault, third-round pick of Anaheim, 4 years in the league. They'll want to move him up. He had a good season, 45 goals and 51 assists. He was in the top 20 in league scoring. 5-1 Belleville. Second period, game 7, OHL Finals. Jacobson and Lawmaster back. Lawmaster back to Jacobson. Now he'll enter center ice territory. It's a long shot right down eye high, gloved by Chiarello, and he'll hand it off behind the net. On to the near side for Chris Kelly. He has the lone London goal. Snuck in behind the Belleville defense, was left all alone, and he scored late in the first period. But the Bulls get it back early in the second. 5-1 the score. Lawmaster to center. Dumps it up on the left wing side. Nate Robinson streaks into the left wing corner for it. And in there against Metcalf, Robinson got a stick on it. That would have negated an icing call. Metcalf out of the corner. Bank pass to center. Into the skates, Meze guides that to Lawmaster. Back to Meze, out to Renzi at center, and Renzi will shoot it down the ice. Stepping off for a line change. Newbury picks off a pass at the line and keeps it in. Intercepted by the Knights down deep, and they'll get it to center ice, and Patton steadies that with the glove and then feeds a high one out to the London line. It's batted ahead and will be called. 12:43 left in the second. Belleville 5, London 1. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Justin Papineau in a bouncing puck along the near boards. Hit a dent in the ice and almost went down. He did lose possession, and then Petteri gave him a shove on the boards. Papineau gets out of it, cuts to the front of the net, pounds one on goal. And Chiarello is there and holds the fort, as Papineau looked like he might sneak one underneath the London goaltender.
And Papineau leading these playoffs in scoring with 21 goals, 46 points. And I would say a good candidate for the brand new Wayne Gretzky trophy to be given to the playoff MVP. And Papineau, with that 21st goal, broke the record set by Danny Gratton for playoff goals by a Bull.
Didn't break it, he shattered it. The old record was 30 points.
No, I'm talking goals.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Danny Gratton scored 20 goals.
So you have Murray Hogg, who just came in, a former Bull, and Craig Mills is here, and so is James Boyd. Some ex-Bulls coming here to cheer on their alumni. Or they're the alumni. Cheer on the folks who wear the sweater they once did. John Chichu at center. Ryan Reddy bumped by Henry. He'll steal the puck there, lead it on to Legault, and it's broken up by Chichu. He's on a mission tonight. John Chichu backhanding it in from center. In behind the net goes Chiarello. Clear around into the skates of Kelly. He'll get it to the point. Patton will dump it in wide of the goal. Ryan Reddy breaking away from Henry. Behind the net for Papineau. Papineau on the backhand again steers it behind the goal, and here's Reddy in for it. Reddy around the goal. Ryan Reddy against Alex Henry. And they end up on the boards, and Henry pulls the puck free. And heads behind his net. 11:40 left in the second period. 5-1 Belleville. Fanta tried to one-hand it around Meze. It didn't work. And the Knights will get it out at center. Knocked down. Picked up at the defense. Played ahead by Meze. And over a London stick at the line. Here's a race for it. Derek Campbell in there. Short side and a sharp angle. And he one-timed it right on Gene Chiarello.
Derek Campbell, who scored some big goals for Belleville in these playoffs, nearly made it 6-1 as he jumped on a loose puck and tried to put it on the short side by Chiarello. Chiarello made a good save.
Mentioned this broadcast is going all over the place. London Cable, Rogers there watching this one. Cable View 4 in Belleville. And next door, the Wally Dever Arena, with the screens are set up again. Hello to you folks in there tonight. And the big screens are courtesy of Loyalist College. Bruce Parker, the Dean of Media Studies. Thank you very much. It's where the overflow crowd is gone. And of course, live on CJBQ Belleville and Ottawa Sports Radio 1200. Off the draw, in the circle, London zone. Doyle races it to center, backhands it down the ice, bouncing puck just wide of the Belleville net, Rady Vojevic on it, clears it the long way back, mid-calf, left point, picks it up, centers it, changes direction in front, right off of Doyle on goal, and Corey Campbell makes the save, and he didn't have much time to react.
Good shot by Jason Metcalf through a crowd, and Campbell had to be very alert. Jason Metcalf generating a lot of offense for the Knights from the defensive position. And one of the reasons why that trade that sent Adam Colagiacomo to the Oshawa Generals has also paid off in spades for the London Knights.
Well, the Oshawa Generals had their shot 2 years ago when they went to the Memorial Cup in Hull. Made it as far as the semifinals. Adam Colagiacomo perhaps not as big a factor in that particular series as it was expected, but Bill Stewart, of course, they had some pretty good hockey players there, including Mark Savard and others. And so it worked for them, and now the Knights are getting the benefits of that deal. Shot, Metcalf right on, big rebound in front of the net. Belleville is there to pull it away, and Chris Stanley. He feeds Derek Campbell on the right wing in over the line, snaps a shot on, and Chiarello makes the save. And the Bulls are shooting on Chiarello from all over the ice. London will take the rebound. It's fed rink wide. Jason Doyle went back for it. Instead, it's Metcalf who gets it. Joel Sherbin in on the right side. Got the shot right on goal. And Campbell squeezes his pads against the left post. And he holds on. 10:38 left in the second. 5-1 Belleville. This is Cronin's Home Building Center. Belleville Bulls Hockey. Is there to cut it off for London. Gets it down deep. Barch tries to center. It's off a skate. Petteri behind the net. Reynolds was coming in. The pass doesn't connect. And the puck will come out to center ice. Henry will feed it off the wall. Almost intercepted by Randy Rowe. Instead, it's picked up by Chris Barch. Fires it ahead. Kostopoulos deals off onto the wing to Reynolds. And the big defenseman will hit the line and shoot it in. And it's going to exit the ice surface. Nobody seemed to see it leave. till Jason Lawmaster pointed it was over the glass. And we have 10:06 remaining in the second period of play. Thanks tonight to our producers, Jason Cheese in Belleville and Steve Lloyd in Ottawa. 5-1 the score here at the Yardman Arena, favoring the Belleville Bulls.
And I have to hearken back to two big hits in the first period when the London Knights were on the power play. And first Ryan Reddy and then Randy Rowe, who was really Ryan Reddy Jr. And the two of them just dealt out a couple of devastating body checks. Reddy's was on Rico Fatta, and he hasn't been a factor since.
Fatta is on the ice against Glenn Crawford, although somebody might be waved away from this faceoff. Crawford hasn't moved an inch. Fatta has gone for a little skate, but he will come back to the dot. Midway point, second period, 5-1 Belleville. Kelly Patton airmails one down the ice, and Reynolds will pick it up at the hash marks. Peter Reynolds, rated high by NHL Central Scouting, getting it out to center ice territory. Crawford is on it, plays it in off the boards. Reynolds has it again, gets turned around in his own zone. Now stepping out at center. Can't get through Derek Campbell. Legault will pick it up and shoot it in, and the puck comes behind the net. Kelly Patton went the wrong way. Legault will come in on this and pick it up on the left wing side, getting it to Fatta, centering it in front, and it's off a London stick, and the Bulls will pick it up. Kelly Patton feeds it on to Derek Campbell, and he'll shoot it into the right wing corner. Patton is there. He swats it to the side of the London net, and the Knights will pick it up, and it will be played by number 8 Schaefer, but not out. A bull is dumped on the play. It's Campbell as the Knights get it out to center. Schaefer guides it on to the far boards. Belleville getting it back at their line. Derek Campbell has to back up to keep it onside. He does so and then plays it in. He'll head off for a line change. Vansevsky clears it around on the right wing side for Jason Doyle to center, where he's cut off on the boards. Still gets it ahead to the line. Joel Sherman on the backhand trying to drive the front of the net. He's denied by Jacobson, and Belleville will get it up but not out. Ryan Reddy was stopped just ahead of the blue line. Knights Jansevsky shooting it. Missed the net. Comes off the boards. Lawmaster sweeps it to the line but not out. And Erskine will keep it in. And Knights now with some sustained pressure territorially as Jansevsky comes in off the point to keep it in. Lost it. Chichu clears it. And a rolling puck back to the neutral zone. Erskine will feed it to Kelly. Kelly rink wide to Doyle on the center ice line. Bouncing it in wide of the Belleville net. Lawmaster bumped by Kelly. And he too is ranked highly by NHL Central Scouting. And Chris Kelly will likely end up being a top 2-round pick. Vansevsky to his right. Erskine intercepted by Papineau as he is decked by Bartsch. He'll shoot it into the zone from his knees. Knights bring it out. Richard Petteri into the slot. Petteri is being stood up on the play. Loose puck off the boards. Kept in by Erskine at the left point. Rolled along the boards to Kostopoulos. Checked by Reddy. Now the battle in the corner. Meze picks it up, sweeps it around the ice, and it will be tipped by Papineau out to center. John Chichu on the loose puck and across the line. Oh, he took ice stick by Erskine, picks it up and scores! Chichu, hat-trick!
What an individual effort by Jonathan Chichu, who skates through a high stick and gets to the front of the London net and then beats Chiarello with a wrist shot by the glove side. Jonathan Chichu, one of the most skilled players in the Belleville lineup. And for those watching on cable view or Rogers, you see why. Shakes off the high stick and the chops and then beats Chiarello.
And of course, that exchange goes back to game 6 on Sunday night in London as Chichu nailed Erskine on the boards and rang his bell. Chichu ended up getting kicked out of the game. Replays show it was a marginal penalty at best. However, Erskine comes back, levels the high stick right at Chichu's face. Chichu fends off part of it with his stick, then walks in and scores his third of the game. 6-1 Belleville.
The SS number 17, Justin Papineau. And number 11, Ryan Reddy.
Papineau with another point. Ryan Reddy, another assist. 6-1 Belleville. 7:23 left in the second. This crowd is on its feet. Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Faceoff to the left of the London net. Knights down as they're going for the breakaway pass to Fata, but he's way across two lines. Well, the Knights are going to have to resort to that kind of a play. It worked for them a lot in game one. The breakaway pass off the boards and with a guy with the kind of speed that Rico Fata has. But they have to try and time it. This is a long ice surface, Tommy, but it's not that long where Fata can get about a 130-foot jump.
It's desperation time now for the London Knights, so Belleville Bulls have to be aware of that guy sticking in behind them, but also it will increase probably the number of opportunities for Belleville as the Knights have to gamble now.
They win the faceoff in their own zone. This time they'll try it up the middle to Fata. He didn't even see it coming. Picked off by Patton. His pass intended for Campbell. That's broken up, and there's Glenn Crawford throwing a hip check on Tyler Durham, who might be seeing his first ice of the night.
Yep.
7 minutes remaining in the second, 6-1 Belleville. Now the Bulls will break 2-on-2. Meze to Campbell. On the right wing and across the line, the left-handed shot, sending it back in the middle to Meze, but it's intercepted, and now Metcalf will try and feed Legault in behind the defense. That goes too far. He'll pick it up behind the Belleville net. Joel Sherbin. Back to the line. Reynolds, snapshot high. It's off the glass side of the net, tipped out in front. And Derek Campbell will try and sweep it around the defenseman. Now it's tipped out in front. They score! The Knights get one back on a deflection. And again, the Belleville defense not paying enough attention to the front of the net. And there was a London forward there to steer it in. It's now 6-2.
Yeah, it was a deflection from a weird angle. Thrown out in front, and the London Knight player was actually tied up by the defenseman, but the defenseman wasn't able to keep his stick from getting on the ice.
Shane Legault was the one to center it. I can't see who it was who deflected it because the defenseman was in the way, but the player was not tied up. And it went to the far side of the net. The Knights get one back at 13-28. 6-2 Belleville. You know the Knights aren't going to quit. They've proven that. Mike Mazzucca gets it. Randy Rowe comes back with a hot shot right from the line. Well, Mike Mazzucca gets his fourth goal of the playoffs. That evens what he did all season long. And that, I think, is his first shift of the night. So Gary Agnew finally goes to the bench, and it works. Back to Jason Lawmaster, snaps a shot right on, and it bounces off Kelly to Petteri, and he'll clear it. And Mike Jacobson. Bulls are going to have to keep their head up and react quickly because London is desperate now. Down by 4 and 6 minutes to go in the second. And they want to try and get in this game before the period is out. And we know the Knights are more than capable of doing it. In behind the London goal. Randy Rowe tips it back. Justin Papineau forced to the outside. Throws it right off the corner boards. It skips back on goal and is gloved by Gene Chiarello. 5:37 to go here in the second. 6-2 Belleville. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Welcome back to the Yardman Arena. Jack Miller, Tom Gavey, 6-2, favoring the Belleville Bulls. Craig Mills, former Belleville captain, now the Chicago Blackhawks, will join us during our second intermission.
And you know, guys like Mills and Hogg that are here tonight and James Boyd are the guys that set the foundation for this.
They were on the team that made a couple of appearances in the league semifinals in back-to-back years. A few years back.
A guy like Ryan Reddy, who's still in the Bulls lineup, don't think he didn't learn from a guy like Mills and a Boyd, Murray Hogg. That's funny that those three should be here because those three, to me, on that team were three of the leaders on that team and the character guys. Maybe that's why they are back.
Exactly. they never forget.
Yep.
And for those listening in Ottawa, Craig Mills' father is Greenwood MP Dennis Mills, who of course has put together quite a report on sports in Canada. making a number of recommendations, and apparently quite a few of those 60-plus recommendations, if I'm not mistaken, are getting consideration from the federal government. We have a problem getting this faceoff going, and the problem seems to be who's going to take it. Steve Miller, the linesman, directing traffic. Chichu comes in on the faceoff. Back to the line, kept in by Patton. Lane underneath the legs of Miller into the corner. Rico Fata will pick it up. Clears it around to Doyle on the far side. And he won't get it out. Instead, it's Papineau in front of the goal. Chichu scores! How about that?
This Belleville team is so good at cycling the puck down low, and they keep it in London territory. And a beautiful feed from Papineau to Chichu in front. Chichu waits for Chiarella to go down, come in himself, and then tucks it into the open net for his fourth of the night.
7-2 Belleville as Chichu is eating up the London Knights. Four goals in this game.
Man, funny, Jack, I was talking to a guy before the game, and he said to me, I give him all the credit in the world, he said, you know, the guy who could be the game breaker is Chichu. And he hit the nail right on the head.
Justin Papineau is up to a goal and four assists. And that is 50 postseason points. Stop and think about that for a minute. That is Chichu's ninth goal in this series, 14th of the playoffs. He is just chewing up the Knights and spitting them out. And he was pumped tonight. Fata to the line, can't get around Lawmaster, and now the Bulls will pick it up, and Crawford feeling it off on the right wing side. Derek Campbell will shoot it in, and it's Stanley down low. Papineau with a goal, and did I say three assists or four? Check me on that, please.
Tell
me I'm losing track. Yeah. I think it's a goal and three assists, which would only give him 49 points. Derek Campbell out at center for Belleville. Crosses.
Goal and three.
Goal and three, so 49 points. He'll just have to try harder. Knights coming out of their zone. They're down by five. There's the shoot-in. March into the left wing corner. Hammers it off the boards. Legault takes it on the other side. Into the middle. Jancevski walks in and shoots. Put it right off the goalpost. Campbell make that. Robinson back on the right wing with speed in over the line. And his wrist shot is blocked by Erskine, who then comes back and ensures Robinson can't get back into the play. Knights will clear it, 4 minutes remaining in the second period. Meze in front of his net, long outlet. Robinson missed it. This will probably go for icing, and does. Jancevski is back. 3:49 remaining in the second period. Belleville 7, London 2. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Face-off will be to the left of Corey Campbell. The shots on goal are 27-19 Belleville. And in this period, they are 15-8 Bulls. Knights pressing in front of the net. Shot right on goal. Corey Campbell with the save. Randy Boyevich after the loose puck out at center. But they're going to bring him back. Whistles going all over the ice. As I think there's a penalty to Nick Policelli about 100 feet behind the play. Holding the stick. Or obstruction hooking will be the call against Nick Policelli.
And Jack, here all the way from Moose Factory, Ontario, Jonathan Chichu's family, and they're all just across the ice from us. There's about two rows of Chichu family members. What a thrill for them tonight. And Moose Factory, folks, is up near James Bay, on James Bay. And to get there, and we know from an equipment drive this year, you have to take a train, I think a moose, and a ferry.
Not necessarily in that order. You have to take the moose out of Belleville. Knights will get their fifth power play. They have been turned away at every turn by the Belleville penalty killers. They're going to start them off in the same fashion. Down the ice, Ryan Reddy, first man back. Feeds it behind the net for Papineau. Of course, those two have teamed up on a shorthanded goal or two in the postseason, not to mention in the regular campaign. Knights are up with this, get it down the ice. Stray pass picked off by Meze. Dispatched to center. Erskine at his line gets it. 3 minutes left, second period, 7-2 Belleville. Erskine lifting it down off the boards. Meze doesn't go after it, and the Knights will get it instead. And it will be Kostopoulos on the far side. Cycles this one in for Fata. Turned over. This time Meze will get it to the line, but not out. Ryan Reddy is in there against Kostopoulos. The puck comes free. Papineau is there and shoots it down the ice. Minute and five to go on the Policelli penalty. Bulls get change in penalty killers now with a minute left in the assignment. Randy Rose on a loose puck, picks it up, brings it in, crossing the line, fires it rink wide, and Sherbin takes it off the boards with a drop pass, and the Knights will bring it out, led by Chris Bartsch. Long rink wide feed off the skate of Doyle, and into the corner with Mike Jacobson lining him up, bumping him, but not taking him off the puck, and Doyle comes around the boards, holding up on the near side. Gets it down low to Bartsch, back to the line to Henry. Took it in the skates, fields back. Bartsch goes to Medcap. He scoops it in off the boards, well wide of the net. Back to the point, Medcap rifles it in wide again. Knights are able to keep it in deep in the Belleville zone. Doyle at the hash marks, moving in, tries a shot, ricochets off the skate. Chichu in front of the net, shoots it down the ice. 13 seconds remaining in the Policelli penalty, and a minute and 45 remaining in the second period. It's a 7-2 Belleville lead. Fata after a loose puck, Kelly coming down the middle, and Fata overskates it. Now he's tied up by Meze, but gets out of it. Rico Fata back to Henry, left point wrist shot, short side, blockered off by Campbell as Patton goes after the loose puck behind the net. Schaefer is on Kelly Patton. Kelly on the puck to Fata in front, and his shot is blocked. And then Henry ends up giving it away. Off the boards to Crawford at center with Chichu. Crawford to Chichu in front. And Chichu couldn't quite catch up with it. That's about the only thing that hasn't bounced his way in the game. Ended up right on goal. Knights are 0-for-5 on the power play. Derek Campbell doing a nice job, pulling the puck away in his own zone. Crawford there for Belleville. Final minute, second period, Stanley out at center. In across the line. Stanley on his backhand, feeds it behind the net. And Henry will then deal it back for Kelly to get rid of it, and he does, to center ice. Richard Petteri tries to skate away from Crawford and does. In the slot, a shot. It's blocked. And Lawmaster and Kostopoulos bump, but not before the Belleville defenseman clears the zone. Petteri will bring it to the line, handing off Kostopoulos. He runs into a brick wall named Mike Jacobson. And Belleville giveaway in the defensive zone. It's dumped in deep off the boards by Petteri. Now Belleville will try and get it out again. There's going to be another penalty coming up as Bill Prisniak has his arm pointing north. And let's see which way this is going. I think it's against London. 21 seconds remaining in the second period. And it looks like Belleville will get their fourth power play of the game. And again, it's Jay Legault, the penalized player.
Blind giveaway a moment ago by Chris Stanley, and that set up a London scoring chance. And although it is 7-2 in Belleville's favor, you still want to be careful. You still got a full period left. And as we've seen in this game of junior hockey, sometimes there's no such thing as a safe lead.
No kidding. Now the Bulls haven't made too many mistakes in this one.
No.
Len Crawford set the tone at 7:47. And that was an appropriate time because it was his speed that put him through the defense on a breakaway, scoring his 13th of the season from Nick Policelli. And the Bulls have not looked back. They had a 4-0 lead at the 16-minute mark of the first period. There have been some big leads posted by both teams in this series. Papineau on through center. This is Belleville's fourth power play. They've scored once. Chichu, right point shot. Looking for the deflection, didn't get it. Vanny Vojvic has a long way to go, but catches up with the puck at the line and keeps it in. Period comes to an end. As Belleville add a pair to the lead after a 3-goal second period. 7-2 Bulls after two periods of play. Will be 4 goals in this game and 9 in this series. Hard to believe he only had 5 goals in the first 3 series against Sudbury, Ottawa, and Oshawa. Underway here in the third period, Belleville on the power play. Papineau shoots it across, Chichu on the far boards. Back into the middle, Randy Rose shoots one. Rocket off the glass, and Chiarello snares it on its way back in front of the net.
That puck exploded off the glass, and Chiarello did a good job of finding it and then keeping hold of it, or Belleville would have had a big rebound to look for. And you remember in game one of this series, Jack, that Jonathan Chichu couldn't buy a goal? He must have had about 9 shots in that first game, but couldn't hit the net. That was the game the Bulls lost in overtime.
Vengasov to the left of the London goal, 7-2 is the lead. Patton down low to Chichu, works his way up the boards, looks at the point, feeds it. Patton back to Chichu. Now he'll deal it in behind the end line. Reddy back to Chichu. Back to Reddy, side of the net. Ryan Reddy looks back for Chichu, has him, top of the circle for the shot, right on. And this time Chiarello will stop it. He will not give up a rebound. And we get a little shoving in front of the goal. And the big thing now is the Knights have to keep their composure, because there's no other way to go except try and get back in this game. And the Bulls have to keep their composure. They can't let the feelings get ahead of them. The job is not done yet. And Lou Crawford, knowing the way he speaks, that's probably part of the message he would have delivered during the second intermission.
You just now, you try to win. If you're Belleville, you try and win every shift and just kill the clock. Every second that you kill is like gold.
Lawmaster keeping it in at the left point, and a backhand pass to Radivojevic in the corner. And Branko Radivojevic steps off the boards and shoots right on. And the rebound is over the stick of Chris Stanley, who then got decked by Erskine. And Belleville gets it back. Lawmaster near boards, working in Radivojevic. Another shot right on as Chiarello goes down and stops it and makes sure there's no further play. We're 1 minute gone in the third period. 39 seconds remaining in the penalty to Jay Legault.
And Belleville getting some good pressure on this power play. Randy Rowe a moment ago. Randy Rowe sometimes will play a power play up front as a forward and then drop back and play the other half of the power play on the point.
Leafs and Pittsburgh tied at 1 in the second. Colorado leads Detroit 2-1 in the second. Last we have from there. Down the ice, it's flipped. Out of the net starts Campbell. Now he gets back in. Last thing the Bulls want to do is open any avenue for the Knights to get back in this. They'll play it cautiously. Papineau at center. Kostopoulos holds on to him with the toe of his stick. Papineau breaks through that, picks it up in the corner, plays it back on the boards, over the stick of Chichu, and it comes back to the point and out. Chichu, the first man back, now Randy Rowe. Bringing it in on the left wing side, drops it back for Reddy. Back into Rowe, cuts to the front of the net, centered in front, shot by Chichu, point blank, and this one is stopped, and the rebound is cleared. And it looks like all the Bulls want to do is feed 19 for Belleville to see how many he could get. He's at 4 in the game. Drops it back to Papineau, open, shooting off of Chiarello. And Papineau gets his own rebound, another spank at it. And at the side of the goal, Chiarello covers up, played 153. Of this third period, 7-2 Belleville on Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Jack Miller and Tom Gavey, Yardman Arena, Game 7 of the OHL Championship. Belleville wins a face-off, and Lawmaster cranks it off the pole. Jacobson tips it into the left-wing corner. Here is a centering pass for Crawford. Can't shoot it around the defenseman Reynolds, who gets it to the line but not out. Lawmaster will keep it in, dealing off to the left-wing corner. Reynolds sweeps it behind his net, picked up on the other side, giveaway in the slot, and Jacobson couldn't handle it. He does manage to corral it at the line and backhand it in. And now into the corner goes Derek Campbell against number 6, Alex Henry. And the Knights, Rico Fatta streaks in on a loose puck. Fatta outlets to center. It will be played ahead by Kelly. He has one of the 2 London goals. Doyle into the corner, dropping it back to Kelly. Reynolds comes in at the right point for the pass. Takes the shot, changes direction in front as Fatta swings and misses at a bouncing puck. Long shot on goal by Metcalf. Into the corner, Fatta back to the line, and Metcalf reaching, but he can't hold it in. Now a good job by Crawford, who then had the stick taken out of his hand as Chiarello was coming out of the net. He ends up running into Crawford as well, and there will be a holding the stick penalty against the London Knights. Great speed by Crawford.
Yeah.
And boy, he paid for it on that shift. But he draws London into a penalty, and the Bulls will get their fifth power play.
Well, Glenn Crawford's night is going to be largely overshadowed by Jonathan Chichu's four-goal effort. But Glenn Crawford has had a marvelous night here and got things going in that first period with that goal and two assists. Glenn Crawford, a guy who toiled in this league for four previous years with some pretty bad hockey teams, getting his reward this year.
Bulls back in the power play. The Knights will clear it to center ice. Papineau after it. Left wing side, tips it to the point. Swept that by Ryan Reddy. Then he picks it up and puts it off the skate of Papineau. It will find Erskine. And that'll go between the defense as Randy Rowe comes back and he gets a hold of Legault's stick with his own. And he will force the play as Belleville will take it back. Papineau out at center ice. And it will be brought down the ice. Reddy heading to the net. As Papineau takes it around, the goal still with it. Feeds the high slot area. Pushed in front by Patton, and that is blocked. Back to the left point. Chichu is there for Belleville. John Chichu floats a cross-ice pass for Papineau, taken off the boards as he backs up to the line. Takes the shot, goes to the slot, gets it back from Patton. Papineau will shoot it, and that one's off Chiarella. Rebound, score! Ready!
London net both on and off the power play to start this period. And a big shot from the point. The rebound comes to Ryan Reddy, and he backhands it by Chiarello.
10th goal of the playoffs for Ryan Reddy. It comes on the power play, and the Bulls have opened an 8-2 lead. Working the points effectively, Papineau and Patton were both back there, and then the shot came from Papineau, standing just inside the line. As he pounds it down, Chiarello made the initial stop. The rebound came to Reddy on the backhand, and he finishes the play. Bulls are in there for another shot by Rady Boyovich. Camped in at the line by Rick Bertrand, who has not seen much ice in this game. Of course, he hasn't seen much ice in the playoffs. So Luke Crawford getting him out there to get his legs. 8-2, Belleville in the lead. Ready with his 10th, Papineau and Patton will draw the assists. And now it doesn't seem like there's a whole lot left to be decided, does there? 15:35 remaining in the third, and some might suggest hasn't been anything to be decided since the end of the first. But this is junior hockey. You take nothing for granted, especially against an outstanding London team that just does not quit. A2 Belleville, this is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Leafs and Pittsburgh tied at one in the second. Colorado leads Detroit 5-2 in the second now. Colorado's played so well on the road in the playoffs. Now if they could only pull their act together at home. Playing is in the center ice zone, 8-2 Belleville. John Chichu has four goals in this game. And the rest of the offense pretty much spread out. Mazzucca, he has a goal for London. And the puck, and he ends up icing it away. It's waved off. Lawmaster behind his net. 5 minutes gone in the third period of play. Newbury and Renzi and Robinson are on the ice. Puck just gets past Newbury and fed ahead by Jansevski at the line to Kelly. Newbury ran into Kelly and put him on the floor as the puck comes back to the line and trickles to center. Jansevski, pass across, picked off by Sherbin and backhanded in, and Sherbin will head off for a line change. Lawmaster behind the goal for Belleville. On to the left wing side for Nate Robinson. Then there's a pass to Renzi at the line, broken up by Erskine. Now Rico Fatto with room to move, hits the line shooting, and that one's off Campbell into the corner. Doyle is on the rebound, gives it up, Belleville coming away. Meze plays it to Renzi. He crosses center, puts on the brakes, comes cross ice, and will make a line change, and the crowd cheering with the end of every shift. Closing in on the 6-minute mark of this third period of play, Meze ahead to Derek Campbell. Looks at the clock, sees about 10 more minutes on there than he wants to, as Doyle will get around Meze, off back to Fata, shoots it, right on goal, and Corey Campbell the save. And Belleville's Derek Campbell will bring it to center. Down the left wing, in over the line with Stanley. Derek Campbell, short side, and holding the skate to the pole is Chiarello, and the puck is in there as well.
Well, 13:46 now left in this third period, and excuse me. Belleville Bulls just looking so much more like the team that swept by the Sudbury Wolves, Ottawa 67s, and Oshawa Generals before this series. And maybe more in this game than any game in this seven-game series looking like that team.
Belvo winning the faceoff. Jacobson hammers one just wide of the net. It may have been deflected. Now Petiri losing it. Mark Chaplin to the line to Lawmaster. One-time shot. He shanked it. Actually, it ended up in trouble in front of the net where Randy Rowe was almost able to deflect that shot. Jacobson again at center. Now he doubles back inside his own line, finds an opening and clears it to center ice. Chaplin shooting it ahead, Rowe brings it in. Rowe for Rady Voyevich, tried to sidestep Jansevski. It didn't work, and the Knights are bringing it out. It's led by Bartsch, angled into the left wing corner to Petiri. Around Lawmaster, centered in front, shot right on, and Campbell comes up with a kick save. Jansevski right on. There's another stop by Campbell. Rowe sweeps the puck ahead to Rady Voyevich, hits the line, shooting it. Low drive and gloved by Chiarello, and he will get a faceoff here with the play inside the London zone. And 7:04 in the books here in the third period. It's 8-2 Belleville in Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Off to the left of the London goal. Knights off the draw. Jason Medcalf, overage defenseman up the middle for Kelly. Broken up by Meze, swept in by Reddy on the near boards. Down low goes Chichu against Medcalf. As they battle for it, Medcalf will kick it ahead for Chris Kelly, and he will outlet, and it's picked off in the center ice zone by Branislav Meze. For Reddy, picks it up for Belleville. Reddy gently plays it in. Into the corner goes Medcalf to pick it up for the Knights, and Medcalf will get it up to the line. Sherbin will finish the job by clearing it to Kelly across two lines and by the narrowest of margins, and they're going to bring the faceoff inside of the London blue line. 8-2, Belleville in the lead. Chichu with four, Crawford, Papineau, and Reddy. And Rady Voyevich.
Saw Gene Chiarello a couple of moments ago when there was a puck and he stopped and was going to clear. He just picked it up and tried to bat it almost like a cricket player. And then a minute later, when they blew a whistle, he had his arms up on the back of the net in resignation. Gene Chiarello, of course, has nothing to hang his head about in this season or these playoffs. But he's starting to see the handwriting on the wall now, Jack.
Well, A2 would certainly suggest then it's just a matter of 12 minutes and 15 seconds to wrap this one up. Jacobson with the shoot in from center. Chiarello behind the net, fires it off the glass, back to the point. Lawmaster sends a high one. It's knocked down in front, and the Knights will come away led by Reynolds. Reynolds hits the line and shoots it in off the boards. Lawmaster behind his net. He will play it off the far side and just nicely touched to get it down to the line at the far end of the ice, so it wasn't going to be enough to go for icing. And a loose puck is rolling back out to the center ice zone. Kelly Padden is there, beating it out. Fata intercepting him. Crawford is on him quickly. What a job Glenn Crawford has done on Rico Fata tonight. Not only that, but Crawford with a goal and two assists, all in the first period to show for it. And Fata has been limited to maybe One good scoring chance. Now Crawford intercepts him, walks in and shoots. And they pound away at the side of the goal after the stop by Chiarello. Centered again, and the Knights will intercept with Mazuka moving out to center ice. Sault Ste. Marie native will shoot it all the way down, and Pat will go and get it with just over 11 minutes remaining in this third period. Chaplin at center will angle it in. Off the boards, Chancevsky turns it to the outside, gets it cleared to center. Lawmaster drops it back for Jacobson. In turn to Lawmaster, now his feed to Rowe on the left wing boards. And across the line, Rowe, Chaplin, centering pass, and Rady Vojevic was there and he couldn't make contact on the business end of that down low 2-on-1. Knights will play it off the boards. It's cleared by Schaefer. Down the ice, giving chase is Jacobson. He's being pursued by Doyle. The two end up in there. Doyle centers. Randy Rowe came right down the middle and picked it off in front of his net. Here's the handoff to Lawmaster. He will lift one out to the center ice zone. 9.5 minutes gone in the third period. Rady Vojevic in across the line and stopped cold, and the Knights will bring it back the other way. Richard Petteri. There's Papineau, gets a beat on him, puts a partial check on Petteri, comes back with a centering pass, and it's off Barch's stick into the corner. Barch will get it back again. He has nowhere to go with it. Now he'll get free and make the play to the point. Jancevski to Barch, steered into the corner. Policelli and Kostopoulos and Rowe all coming in for this, and it will be Rowe for Belleville getting it out. Here's Chichu. He's bodied off the puck by Henry and hauled down. Belleville still on it. Chichu in front of the net. Shoots!
Unbelievable. 5-goal night for Jonathan Chichu, as the London Knights defenseman slides by the puck, a perfect feed from behind the net, Papineau to Chichu, bang, bang, into the net.
Chichu's 15th of the postseason, one-third of them have come in this game. He takes the feed from down low and finishes the play like he's been doing all night long. And it looks like Papineau is going to get that 50th playoff point.
Yep, and there's the sign, Jack. Unraveled by some Belleville fans, start the bus.
I'm not sure if they're referring to the bus to London or the bus to Ottawa.
His 15th of the playoffs, his 5th goal of the night, scored by the team. This is number 17, Justin Papineau. And number 2, Nick Policelli.
Papineau and Policelli drawing the assist. Papineau with a 5-point night and a 50-point postseason. How about that? And Policelli with his second assist in the game. It is 9-2 Belleville. Guess I better start boning up in the Calgary Hitmen's roster. Because that will be the first game for the Bulls on Sunday afternoon. And our broadcast on CJBQ will begin at 3:45. I think it's fairly safe to say that now, with 9 minutes left and a 7-goal lead. And the Bulls are not giving up an inch. Centering pass by the Knights. Meze clears it off the boards, not out. Knights will keep it in. Legault back into the middle for Kostopoulos. He's wrestled to the ice by Crawford, and it's back to the line again. Here is Reynolds for Legault. He is pinned by Derek Campbell. Padden tries to chop the puck free. Now they do. Crawford has an open man. It's Meze, the defenseman. As he comes to center, he fakes the shot, and that put Derek Campbell offside on the right wing. 8:33 left in the third. This is Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey. Jack Miller and Tom Gavey, Yardman Arena. Now it's just a matter of time. 9-2 Belleville. And the one thing that you've been writing in the Intelligencer and we've been saying on CJBQ and Mix 97, we've been giving the London Knights their due, and justifiably so, as a team that don't quit. And we've also been saying, but the Belleville Bulls are a team that don't quit. And boy, all you have to do is look at the scoreboard to see after two setbacks the way this team has reacted tonight.
Well, my feeling has always been that the test of a champion, of course, is how they handle adversity. Belleville Bulls got their biggest dose of adversity the last two games, and they've come out tonight and obviously shown how they deal with it.
Off the faceoff, night zone, they control. Kelly out at center for Fata. On the outside, Lawmaster is right on top of him, and then Crawford is. The Bulls have not let Rico Fata be a factor in this game. They were not going to let number 96 beat them tonight. He's beaten them in the last two games, including a four-point effort in game five, and all 4 points came in a span of 2 minutes and 33 seconds. But tonight, no factor, much like he wasn't in games one, two, three, and four. And now he runs offside at the line. 7 minutes and 52 seconds remaining in the third period of play. Belleville 9, London 2.
I guess if you were going to write the script for this one from a Belleville Bulls fan's point of view, this would be a pretty good script, but I think all of us coming in here did not expect this, did not expect it to be this kind of a runaway.
Belleville scoring at 7:47 of the first, 10:23, 12:28, 16:02, and they served notice early that this would not be like the last two games. Bulls coming out of their zone. They are led on the right wing by Mark Chaplin. Shoots it in from center, behind the net, cut off by Chiarello, and he's going to shoot it down the ice. Rick Bertrand coming back for this one and picking it up at the end of the rink. Off the right wing boards to Rady Vojevic at his own blue line. Starting away to Chaplin in across the line. Chaplin, drop pass. Rady Vojevic looking for Rowe. He ends up putting it on Chiarello. And now with every stop, Gene Chiarello hearing a little bit of the Bronx cheer. But like you said, he doesn't have to hang his head to anybody. This is a kid that played in 62 of 68 games for the London Knights this season, and all 24 games, now 25 in the playoffs. I mean, he has given the London Knights outstanding goaltending all season long, and there's always a chance he could be back as an overage next year. Possibility exists.
I thought at the start of the series, because I hadn't seen much of him, that he was a little unorthodox, and he certainly isn't any classic style, Jack, but he does the job. He gets the puck stopped, and that's really all you can ask of a goaltender.
Puck is out at center ice. Jacobson turns to the boards, playing it for Robinson, who has to get turned around, but being pursued by Doyle, he'll drop it to Jacobson. Now Lawmaster tries to return it, and it's off of Doyle, and now it's up for grabs in the center ice zone. Mike Renzi off the left wing boards. Robinson heading to the net. Renzi, screenshot! Robinson right there and made contact with Chiarello. Renzi again behind the goal. Mike Renzi against big Alex Henry, and there's a size mismatch physically, but certainly not in terms of heart. Doyle in front of his net gets the pass and then lobs it out at center. Swept at by Lawmaster, picked up by Petrian across the line. Tries to split the defense. He got through but got a weak shot away, so he wasn't through cleanly. And Belleville's coming right back again. Chris Newberry, Renzi and Robinson, the three of them, and Newberry's wrist shot missing the goal. Meze steps in on one, and he fanned on it. It did find the net, and it's turned away by Chiarello. And it's Metcalf for the Knights. Into his final 6 minutes in this sweater. He started out as a member of the Oshawa Generals. He and Jay Legault came together in the Adam Colagiacomo trade 2 years ago. Chichu, hit fakes in across the line. Metcalf knocks him down. That's about the only way you're going to stop John Chichu tonight. And the weird thing is he has scored as many goals in this game as he had in the entire three series prior to this one. He only had 5 goals coming into this series. And suddenly 10 goals here. And as you pointed out, he had a terrible first game. He kept shooting and missing the net.
It was terrible from that point of view, but the good news, of course, for Belleville was that he was getting those scoring chances.
Whoops. Little action after the whistle, and Jason Metcalf wants a piece of somebody. He'll be held back. And Bill Prisniak was calling penalties anyway. So as they sort this out, we'll take a break. With 5:34 left in the third period of play, Belleville 9, London 2. It's just a matter of time. They can start dusting off the J. Ross Robertson Trophy on Cronin's Home Building Center, Belleville Bulls Hockey.
Thank you.
Championships on the home of the Belleville Bulls, CJBQ, as well as on the home of the Ottawa Senators, OSR 1200. London has been turned away at every chance they've had in a power play tonight. The Bulls will start them again here. Back inside their own zone. Schaefer gets around, ready, picking up speed at center, and across the line he goes. On his forehand, tries to drive the net. He centers in front and will pick up his own rebound as it's back to the line. There's a drive from the left point taken by the youngster Steven Roski, who was off the pine for the first time in the game. And out there in the power play mode, ready, brings it slowly in across the line and shoots it around the boards. Erskine picks it up for London. Less than 5 minutes to go in the third period. 9-2 Belleville if you're just joining us. Chichu with five goals. Played by Corey Campbell. Onto the near boards. It's knocked down by Rose Hand. And the puck is sitting at the skates of Mike Mazuka. Can't get a stick on it. As Chichu tried to get it through the point, it's kept in by Barchnett. Erskine, deep slot. Shot deflected in front and just wide. Now on the right point, Roski puts it out in front of the net. Knights Barch moving in, and he fires it back to the line past Erskine, who did a double take over his shoulder as he was heading down the ice to pick this one up. That was about as authoritative as a wrist shot pass as you'll ever see. He just snapped that thing right back through center. 30 seconds left, penalty to Meze. Barch over the line, throws it in the corner. Petiri proceeds in after it, drops it back to Barch behind the net. He's forced wide. Terry gets it back, steering it to the left point. Gets the feed in for Reynolds. Now Reynolds getting it back in the slot. Shot out in front of the goal. There's a loose puck in the slot. And Rowe will chop it up to the line and out. Terry for the Knights. For Reynolds. 8 seconds left. Now a steal by Chichu. Who else? He's going to take it himself and try and tuck it in short side. And he was blocked to his left by Gene Chiarello. No Bull has ever scored 6 goals in a game. Only one has scored 5. Now the Knights coming back with an end-to-end rush led by Petiri. That one is blocked. Power play is over. Knights still with it. Jensevsky is shot. Campbell sees it all the way. 3:20 left, third period. 9-2 Belleville in this Bulls hockey. For Cronin's Home Building Center, this is Belleville Bulls hockey. Just over 3 minutes remaining in the third period. 9-2. Now, one thing about these Bulls, they sure know how to take the drama out of a deciding game. Glenn Crawford down deep, circling the goal, centering it out in front for Derek Campbell. His shot is blocked by Jensevsky. Rinko Fatta with a back pass, but that will miss Doyle. And Fatta comes over to pick it up himself. He can't get anywhere with it. There's Crawford on the forecheck on Fatta again, and he's forced him deep into his own end. Finally, the pass will have to be made to the boards as the Knights get it out. High pass through the neutral zone. And I think they were expecting a whistle. It's like it hit the score block or something. But play goes on. 2 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in this third period of play. 9-2, the Bulls are in the lead. And the crowd beginning to get to their feet. Nick Policelli, breakaway pass for Randy Rowe. He can't hang on to it. Rolls down on Chiarello, and Rowe will pick it up in the corner. Randy Vojevic out in front. Here's Policelli, and he tripped at the last minute. He was getting ready to one-time it, and probably a little too anxious for the young defenseman. And just over 2 minutes remaining. Knights getting it in across the line to Sherbin on the near boards. Sherbin into the corner against Policelli, losing it. Puck rolls out in front, and Mark Chaplin will pick it up for Belleville, and now getting it out into the center ice zone. Under 2 minutes to go in the third period. You can hear the crowd as it bounces inside the Belleville line. Down in the left wing corner, Bertrand and Kelly. They go bumping in for it. Now it's Chaplin on the near side. Mark Chaplin will send it up to the line. It's pulled down by Randy Vojevic. And this crowd is on their feet. Robinson out at center. In across the line. Robinson curls back to the point, feeding it across to Lawmaster, moving in. He shoots it. And he rips one wide of the goal. Back to Meze at the left point. He'll send it in deep. Robinson pulling it out in front. He's smothered. Loose puck. Lawmaster a shot. And it kicks off a night and down the ice. Branislav Meze will come back for this one and take it behind his net. 1:10 remaining in this game, in this series, in the OHL season. Robinson out at center. In across the line. Fakes the shot. Gets in loose. Shooting right on. And a good stop there by Chiarello as they make the one-minute announcement. Eric Campbell feeding it behind the net. The puck is rolling. And Chris Barch will go and get it. Robinson's on it again. Nathan Robinson against Schaefer, who now busts out, blocked by Lawmaster. Bulls are in an offside mode as Erskine will bring it out. 40 seconds remaining in this game. Long shot, Erskine right on, and Jacobson is there and backhands it down the ice and right on goal. 47th shot administered by the Belleville Bulls. Knights deep in their own zone. It will be fed ahead. Out to center ice with Stanley there. 20 seconds left. Bouncing puck into the mitt of Chiarello, and he'll hold on as the timer continues to go. Chiarello will clear it to center and Jacobson to his right. Lawmaster ducks deep inside his own zone. We'll let the crowd take the final 5 seconds. They stop the clock with 5 seconds left.
Balloons on the ice.
I think they wanted to call the play earlier, but maybe nobody heard a whistle. They should just drop it.
That's what they're gonna do.
This game is over. For the first time in their 18-year history, the Belleville Bulls stand alone above all others in the Ontario Hockey League as the OHL champions. When they defeated the Peterborough Petes in 8 games, but that wasn't the final. It may have felt like the final because of the great rivalry between the Bulls and the Petes. They've now taken it one step further. And they will be meeting the Acadie Bathurst T10, Calgary Hitmen, and the Ottawa 67s in the National Championships. The Memorial Cup beginning in Ottawa Saturday, and for the Belleville Bulls, Sunday afternoon at 4 against the Calgary Hitmen. 18 seasons to get to this point, and boy, it sure feels sweet. Crowd is sort of quietening down. They're still on their feet as a table is set up at the end of a carpet, and out comes the J. Ross Robertson Trophy.
And it's delivered there by a Belleville boy, Aaron Bell of the OHL. Asked him before tonight's game, I said, Aaron, do you have to stay neutral or can you cheer? And he said, well, I think everybody would know what I'm thinking.
The Robertson Trophy was first awarded in 1934. It has many names on it, and it's about to add the roster of the Belleville Bulls. And I'll tell you, Tommy, it's a heavy sucker. I picked it up at City Hall during the pre-series press conference, as now the team is down for that tradition now, which is becoming after a championship, where they all crowd around.
All right.
And
there's the song I wanted to hear.
Dr. Vaughn is sitting on the seat of his pants on the ice, and nobody is happier than he is. The Ross Robertson Trophy, first awarded in 1934 to St. Michael's College after they defeated Stratford 2-0. It was presented to the Ontario Hockey Association by John Ross Robertson, who was the president of the OHA in the early 1900s. He was elected to the Hockey Hall of Fame as a builder in 1947. The Oshawa Generals have won the Robertson the most times with 12 wins since 1938. The Belleville Bulls are now 11 behind them. Of course, 1938 There were no Bulls in anybody's eye, obviously. This franchise joining the league in the 81-82 season. Commissioner David Branch, who has been following these teams in the last three games, with a microphone and just waiting to make the presentation of the J. Ross Robertson Cup to the Belleville Bulls.
By the director attention to the center ice area, OHL Commissioner David Branch has some hardware to go.
Thank you very much. Championship series are always a very special time. On the 26th of April of this year, the Board of Governors of the Ontario Hockey League felt it was only appropriate to name a trophy in honor of arguably the greatest player to ever play the game. Named it in honor of Mr. Wayne Gretzky. Given Mr. Gretzky's love and ties to this great community, it is only fitting that the very first recipient be a Belleville Bull.
Getting mobbed by his teammates as the MVP of the OHL playoffs, and there just could not be any doubt. 50 points in 21 games. He will receive the first ever Wayne Gretzky Trophy.
It's a wonder he got out of that group alive. But what a marvelous, marvelous playoff he had, and a marvelous regular season as well.
Papineau receiving it, and actually what he is getting is sort of a mock plaque because they haven't had a chance to fashion an appropriate trophy. The Board of Governors only approved this award on April the 27th.
It's been 18 years. In that time, there's been a number of things that have certainly been ever so evident when you talk about the Belleville Bulls. 17 consecutive years in the playoffs. Outstanding support by arguably the greatest hockey fans in the world. This evening, the past 18 years, would not have been possible if it were not for one person, Dr. Robert Russell.
Boy, ain't that the truth. Robert Vaughn, the owner of the Bulls since day one, being recognized by David Branch.
Part of the rescue team from Tier 2.
Permit me to give the trophy firstly to Bob, and then Bob, if you would be kind enough to present it to your worthy captain.
Dr. Vaughn will be presented with the trophy. And he will then hand it to his captain, Ryan Redding.
Can only imagine what these kids did to get here. practiced every day that they didn't play, almost virtually from day one of the season to this. They practice every day here. They go to school. They have restrictions on them that a lot of other teenagers don't have. And it's all for this. And as these kids sweated, some of them sweat blood and tears.
For every kid dreams about someday hoisting a Stanley Cup and circling the ice in a victorious fashion. And it seems like Queen has fashioned the theme song. But there we are the champions. These players aren't in the NHL. Many of them never will be in the NHL. But none will forget what they are going through tonight as they pass the J. Ross Robertson Trophy, player to player, as they make a very slow circle around the Yardman Arena ice. And now, with very few days off, it will be back on this ice to practice and prepare for the Memorial Cup, which opens in Ottawa this weekend. And for those of you who have been listening to this broadcast on Ottawa Sports Radio 1200, you'll see a Belleville Bulls team that many of you saw in round two against the Ottawa 67s. And I suppose, in a sense, the 67s and their fans can take a little bit of solace in the fact that the team that did beat them out at least went on to win the championship. And having talked with many members of the team, Brian Campbell for one, talking with Jeff Hunt today after being named OHL Executive of the Year, the 67s would love nothing better than a chance to get back at the Bulls. And what better place to do it than in the Memorial Cup. CJBQ will be there every step of the way, beginning with the first game against the Calgary Hitmen. Luke Crawford raises the cup and draws perhaps the loudest cheer. And Fred Boimstruck, the former Cornwall Royal, who won a couple of Memorial Cups, including one against Luke Crawford's Kitchener Rangers back in 1980. Crawford came back and got his ring in 1981 as a member of that very potent Kitchener Ranger team that included the likes of Wendell Young in goal and, of course, Al McGinnis and many others.
There's Paul Shilton. And there's, of course, we got to mention the training staff, Jack. Boy, the job they do. I mean, they work so hard. Chris Rutledge, Paul Shilton, Casey Lamour, Bernie Heideman. That's the support staff. Eric Harvey, of course, in the marketing department and the ticket people.
There's Kevin Baker out on the ice. He has a sweater on, but of course in civvies. He was knocked out of this series in game one. He was knocked out of the last series in game one, a knee injury and then a reoccurrence of the knee injury. And there's a goal a game player that the Bulls have come through two rounds without and have still managed to pull it through as they all take turns passing the cup around and enjoying this very special moment. And of course, they want to do it one more time. One more cup.
Yeah.
Now take it to the fans.
Well, Jack, when they won the East, they refused to come out of the dressing room when the fans called them because they said they had higher purpose this year. And for a while there, it began to wonder, had it backfired on them? But no, it hadn't.
A lot of fans were upset because
they wanted to give
them the appropriate ovation. And now down on the ice they go to pose for another picture, but this time they will do so with the cup. Belleville Bulls are the 1998-99 OHL champions. And now on to Ottawa.